Hi guys! Welcome back to my channel! Today we'll be painting strawberry pie. And yesterday I wasn't able to paint because I was outside and I reported to my office. Well, I reported to the headquarters. And it was just so tiring yesterday because it was like a whole day thing for me. I had to arrange my papers. But yeah, just telling you guys because I was supposed to paint yesterday. Anyway, we'll do our very best today. So I'm starting my morning the right way. So we'll start it with the painting. And let me tell you the colors that we'll be using for today's painting. I'm so excited about this one. We have red, we have permanent magenta, permanent orange, vermilion, permanent yellow light, titanium white, and black. Okay, let's begin now, guys. And we will begin by underpainting our canvas. Okay, so I'll be using red to underpaint the strawberries. I miss painting, and it was only one day that I wasn't able to paint. Gosh. Okay, like that. Underpainting first, guys. I'm gonna mix it with vermilion. Or just paint it red because, again, we're doing the underpainting. So, this is just to give a foundation to our details later. Then I'm gonna get my permanent orange and mix it with a tiny bit of yellow up here. It's not obvious though, but okay, I'm gonna add more yellow. Okay, I'm gonna get my red still. Okay, just like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my permanent magenta mixed with white. So it's like this color. Like that. And then get back to red. You know, I wanna find out why that sound always happens when I'm painting. You know, that like a police or ambulance thing? All right. So I'm still using red, guys. Just red. Okay, I'm gonna get my permanent magenta plus white here. We're starting to identify where the light is, and the light is coming from the left, from the right side. Okay, get back to your permanent orange And I'm not washing my brush because this is they are all within the same shade of color, so it really doesn't matter if you wash it or not. I just don't want to wash it because it's a waste of time. I'm gonna mix my red with burnt sienna and then red like here. I'm just gonna use my fingers to blend or to apply it quite evenly on the canvas. And watering it down. Okay, I'm gonna get my black plus red. Okay, here. Because the light is coming from the right side, so the left side of the painting is quite darker than the right side. Okay, I'm gonna get my burnt sienna. Like that. Okay. I'm gonna use the same mixture, burnt sienna plus black here. We're just doing some depth and shadows. Also here. Okay, like that. Here. Oops, that's too dark. I'm just gonna apply some shadowing. Also here. My advice for beginner painters, do not get overwhelmed by the subject, is to do the subject, do your painting piece by piece, like one by one. You can start from right, from left to right, or right to left, up or down. I mean, from up to down. Doesn't matter, as long as you take it step by step, it's gonna help a lot. It won't overwhelm you at all. Okay, I'm just doing some definition, separating the strawberries from one another by simply outlining it. Okay, like that. So here. Okay, like that. Okay, so we're just trying to define the strawberries before we color them finally. Okay. We're going to get a red and mix with orange. Okay, more orange this time. Okay, like that. All right, also here, it's getting dirty. You can wash your brush out. Wash your brush out because we don't want too much black. Okay, get your orange, red, orange mixture. Okay, some permanent magenta. Okay, orange plus yellow here, like that. Okay, also same color up here. Also here. Okay, like that. And then get your red, your orange yellow or yellow orange. Also here. And here. Top. Okay, get your red. That here as well. Okay. Again, yellow orange. Okay, like that. Okay, so we're done underpainting it, no? Not yet. Here. Okay, and also here. Okay, like that. This is again the underpainting. We'll go back to it in a while. Okay, we're gonna underpaint the crust. Okay, wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my yellow. Okay, and then mix it with burnt sienna. All right, so underpaint it, guys, first. If you're wondering why I'm tapping instead of doing that stroke, that's because this is the crust and it's quite uneven. It has an uneven texture to it. So I really don't mind if my brush strokes are random, because that's actually my goal for this painting. And also, I'm not really covering too much of my sketch so that I still see the where I should highlight it. That's too dark. It's too dark. We're gonna do the highlights later. For now, it's gonna be like this weird. Okay. For now. Okay. Okay. Can wash your brush out. Okay, wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my black. And start doing the plate. Okay, also here, you can water it down. like that. Okay. Okay. Then I'm gonna graze something. So I'm gonna use my black mixture. I'm gonna remove some of my paints, but I'm not gonna wash it thoroughly. I'm gonna mix it with white so that I achieve grayish color, like this color. Okay, I'm just gonna do the background. Background, guys. Okay, I'm gonna get darker gray. Right, like that. Okay, I'm gonna get my white and brighten some area. Okay, I'm gonna brighten this corner. And we're gonna let it dry for a while. And let's go here. Also gray here. Also in gray. Okay, so the whole canvas is now painted. Painted on. So we're gonna do the details now. Wash up a shop. Wash your brush out. Okay. I'm gonna get my yellow. Okay, I'm gonna apply some yellow paints here. And I'm gonna use my fingers just to evenly apply it. Like that. I'm gonna get my orange, try to blend like this. Like that. I'm gonna get my red. I just ran out of red. I'm gonna get my red mixed with burnt sienna. Red, burnt sienna. Right? And I'm gonna apply it here. Blend. Always blend. Like that. Okay. And here I'm gonna apply some dark red. Red with burnt sienna here. Also here. All right. Wash your brush up. Get your orange plus yellow. And then move up. Blend. Like that. Okay. We're gonna do highlights later. For now, it's gonna be like that. Okay, move up. Yellow, more yellow. Okay, just move up. Sorry about that noise, guys. All right. Okay, I'm gonna use the same mixture, yellow here. But the application should be quite, not in a large amount. Okay, I'm gonna get my permanent magenta. Permanent magenta plus white. Okay, like this color. Like that. Permanent magenta. Okay, I'm gonna get more white this time. Oops. Sorry. That's the sound. Okay, so I'm gonna use the permanent magenta plus white somewhere here. Excuse me. All right, like that. And then here. We're just doing the highlights already. You know, I really don't mind doing the highlights in the middle of painting it after underpainting it. You know that? Some people do it last, but to me, I don't mind. I just don't mind doing it in the middle. Okay, permanent magenta here. And here as well. Like that. What is that sound every day? That. So I'm gonna get my vermilion and I'm just gonna continue this area because okay, I'm gonna water it down so that it looks like liquidy. Like that. Here as well. Okay. And then I'm gonna apply some vermilion down here. Like that. Also here. In here. Let's go back. Okay, I'm gonna get my red orange. Sorry, not red orange, yellow orange. In here as well. Some yellow. And yellow here. Yellow here. All right, like that. I'm gonna get my black. Black plus red, because I wasn't able to define this area. This too. And this too. All right. Here. Like that. Okay. I'm gonna water down my black. I'm sorry guys, I'm getting quite annoyed by the sound. Okay, so we're gonna do some shadow down here. Like that. I'm gonna get some black. Like that. I'm gonna mix it with a tiny bit of brown or burnt sienna. And water it down like that. Also here, just to create some shadows. Right, like that. Wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my vermilion plus yellow. And I'm just gonna go around the crust, the top portion of the crust, like this. Okay, like that. Okay, you can wash your brush out. I'm gonna get my lemon yellow. Okay, lemon yellow and white. Okay, like this color. I'm mixing it with some brown color so that it's not absolutely white and yellow. And then we're gonna do some more highlights on the crust. But just dab it like this so that we create some sort of an evenness on the crust. Like that. Okay, like that. So just dab, okay? All right. And then again, we're gonna go around the top portion of the crust to give it quite some sort of highlights as well. Okay, we're gonna leave it dry. We're gonna leave it to dry first, and then we're gonna go back to the strawberries now. So I'm gonna get my burnt sienna plus tiny bit of red. And I'm just gonna make some dots like this. Alright, okay. Wash your brush out. For the strawberries in the foreground or near us, I'm gonna use some yellow plus tiny bit of orange. And then create something like this. office. Okay, here it's yellow. Okay, I'm gonna apply my yellow right here because I missed the highlight on this part. Okay, I'm gonna get my brown and red. Just apply it here again. Okay, like that. Okay, I'm just gonna water it down. So apply some. Okay, like that. Here as well. Just to close it. Like that. Okay, like that. So I'm gonna get my yellow plus white. You can use some orange if you want. And you can paint over those black dots that we did. And then I'm watering down some of my yellows plus white to suggest that this cake is glazed, you know, like that. Like that. Okay, wash your brush out. Okay, I'm gonna make some gray color. I'm gonna get my white plus black. Some gray color. And then just do this. We're gonna paint over this later, but I'm underpainting it. The second underpainting is gray for the highlights. All right. Here. like that. Gonna get more gray. Here. Also here. Okay, I'm gonna use the same gray mixture just to highlight this strawberry. Okay, like that. Wash up, wash up. Okay, I'm gonna use a smaller brush. So I'm gonna get my vermilion. Okay, permanent yellow to create some orange. And some pink color by mixing red and white. So I'm gonna get my vermilion, this one, it's like an orange color. I'm gonna mix it with orange, I mean with yellow, to create some orangey color. And then here, I'm gonna dab it so that it looks natural. All right. Here. Make it more orange here as well. Here. Here, some dabs of yellow. That. Oh wait, I'm gonna go back to my gray, by the way. Make some more highlights. All right, I'm gonna gray something here. I'm gonna get my red, pure red. like that. I'm gonna mix it with vermilion. I'm gonna go around the highlights. Like this. Vermilion. Just dab. Like that. So I'm just using red here and there, watering it down, sometimes orange. I'm gonna darken my red this time. Okay, like this. Alright, wash brush out. Get your vermilion again. Vermilion. If someone asks, what's the alternative for vermilion? It's just red and orange. So it's red orange. Okay, like that. All right, so we're gonna go fix this plate. I'm gonna get my black. Alright, like that. Okay, wash it, wash out. I might use my spoon later as an alternative to palette knife because I think I'll be needing some palette knife on the crust. So I'm gonna get my pure white now. And try to emphasize the highlights, the gray highlights. Now we're moving on to brighter highlights. Okay, I'm gonna use pure white. So I'm just using a white. Here. Okay, so I'm gonna mix my white with some yellow just to create more highlights on the crust. Like that. We're going to highlight the bottom part of the crust. Alright, like that. Okay, wash your brush out. Get some yellow orange, and let's add some details here. As well, and then here. Just tiny, because the strawberries from afar have a blurry effect already, so they cannot be too detailed because that would lose the perspective. I'm gonna get some black plus orange, and I'm just gonna water it down. Oh, it's too much. Too much. I'm gonna get some white plus permanent magenta plus red. I'm just gonna highlight some areas. Again, permanent magenta plus red. plus white. Add white to your magenta, guys. Oops. Like this. Here. Okay. Okay, brush your brush out and then get some pure white. Pure white. Okay. Wash your brush out. Oh, I should not have washed my brush out. Don't wash your brush. I forgot to highlight this part. Okay, I'm gonna wash my brush out this time. I'm gonna get my permanent orange. I'm gonna mix it with yellow. Okay, like this color. I'm gonna dab in. This is the highlight of the strawberry, the top portion. Here. I'm gonna mix it with white plus magenta. Okay, white plus magenta. then white. All right. Okay, wash your brush out. I'm gonna use my yellow orange again. Do some more detailing. Tiny bit of black. Like that. And then just glaze it with black here, down here. And here, black. Like that. Here, black. All right, like that. All right, this I'm gonna do a certain technique that I really like, and that is glazing. I hope it's dry. Anyway, even if it's not dry, fully dry, I'm just gonna glaze. I'm gonna use my vermilion plus yellow, like this color, plus red perhaps. Okay, like this color, guys. And then water. Start glazing it. I'm just gonna glaze it, guys, because I am a huge, huge fan of glazing. Like that. And then I'm just gonna use some damp cloth. Okay, just to remove the excess paints. I'm gonna dab like that. I'm gonna wait for it to dry. I'm gonna get my white. And I'm just gonna go back to the highlights that I glaze over. Like that. Sorry, I just breathe in deeply. Like that. More highlights here. Okay, so I'm just doing some highlights. Okay, we should push up. Gonna get more red orange. I didn't know that this will be this would involve a lot of highlighting. This was a lot of highlighting, guys. I actually did not expect it, but I think it was all worth it. Right. I'm gonna get my permanent magenta plus tiny bit of white. Gonna get my white plus again magenta. Okay, like that. We're almost done, guys. Gotta do it like that so that it looks a little blurry, you know, from afar. Gonna get my red. So I'm just unevenly dabbing in some red. Also here. Okay, we'll keep going, guys, until I am finally happy. Okay, that looks better. Okay, I'm gonna dab in some yellow down here, like that. Also here. The dabbing technique actually makes the appearance of the painting more natural. So if you don't like it, it's all right, but I like it. Very good, Jay. Like that. Like that. Okay. I'm gonna use now my spoon, the back of it, and then I'm just gonna dab in some white here. Just a tiny bit of yellow, like that. Make it just dabbing. We're gonna go to the crust. And then I'm just gonna make some circular motion down here to create that, you know, natural appearance of the crust. Okay, like that. And then I can use now my brush to just evenly like apply it. Like that. To make it more natural. Okay. Yeah, like that. I'm gonna wash my brush out. Then I'm gonna get pure white this time. I'm just gonna brighten this side. That also here. Like that. And then here. Right, like that. Pure white again, and I'm gonna make it quite liquidy and highlight the plate now. All right, and then we go down. Like that. Okay, I'm gonna use my okay, this is like dirty white. I'm just gonna dab in some more highlights to again to make our crust more natural looking. There you go again. Mm-hmm. Sorry about the noise, guys. I'm painting near the window, so I'm hearing all sorts of things outside. Okay. Washabasha! Then I'm gonna get my vermilion. Oh, that's quite dirty. Okay, I'm gonna get my vermilion and just do some. What do you call that? The glaze. Like that. And then get some black. Gonna get some gray. Can I move it like quite here? Yeah, like this. Like that. Okay. Gonna get my cleaner brush. And then get some black, guys. That looks nice. And then again yellow, guys, because it keeps on fading, you know. When I glaze it, it keeps on fading. Okay, wash your brush out. We're almost done. I'm just obsessing about detailing. Almost done. Okay, brush your brush out. Then I'm just gonna get my white or gray. Just gonna lighten this part. Just gonna lighten it, not too much though. I don't mind the contamination of the yellow or the contamination by the yellow paints. Actually, it looks more beautiful when it has it like that. I'm gonna get pure white this time, make this side a little brighter. All right. One last. Just get your pure white and just dab more highlights. Okay, like this, and then I'm just gonna dry brush. Just gonna get my white. Okay, this painting involves a lot of application and reapplication. All right. Wow. wow. I'm so happy about it, guys. Okay. Wow. I'm gonna sign it now. I'm gonna use the black and sign it here. Okay, this is good. This is really good. Okay. One final touch. As usual, guys. As usual. Just tiny bit, you know? Just tiny bit. It's not too much, but I want to add it. Okay. Guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you do this one as well. If you do this one, then please tag me on my Facebook, or just tell me in the comment section below that you did it as well, so that, you know, I'll find out who actually does my tutorials. And if you're just watching, I hope you enjoyed watching me paint. Thanks, guys. Thanks, guys. Love you.